You like my Geralt?
I love your Geralt. Your Geralt and my Geralt should get together and have a pie.
A pie?
Or beer.
So I'm backstage at the Golden Joysticks and I'm sitting next to Geralt Revier, or rather I should actually use his proper name, which is Dan Cockle. How are you doing, sir?
I'm good, thank you very much.
This has been, there's so many things I want to talk to you about. This. I think it must be like such a weird reaction when people kind of find out, you know, you do the voice and then they behave a little bit like this, because they're like, I spent like over 150 hours just listening to you talking.
I'm a witcher. Heard you wondering about my swords. Well, one's for monsters, the other for humans.
Is it weird?
No,
no. Is it now weird? Well, is it awkward now?
No. Okay, no, because you're lovely.
Oh, thanks.
But it is kind of weird. I've come to this award ceremony today, and it's been fantastic. And all these people have said kind of what you said just now, and it just doesn't happen every day. So it is a little bit weird, but it's kind of fun as well.
Doesn't seem like such an ordeal now, does it?
What would you say, the good characteristics to have to be a good voice actor for a game?
All you have is the voice, so you have to put everything into what you're doing with your voice.
Yeah.
So you're absolutely right. It's like a color palette. You know, you've got the primary colors, and with voice acting, you really have to blend the colors quite carefully.
That will be a challenge.
Tell us a little bit how you first got the job.
I knew nothing about it, actually. I never really thought about it when I was training about voice acting for games. It was back in 1999. It was pretty new, actually.
Oh my God.
I just went for an audition. My agent sent me for an audition. I'd never been to an audition for a game before. I auditioned for this game called Independence War 2, Edge of Chaos.
And that classic.
and got the lead role, and that's where I started. And I just kind of, picked it up as I went along. Witcher 1, it was a shot in the dark for CD Projekt Red. They thought, well, this is really cool, and we think this will work. But it was, a complete roll of the dice. And then it worked really well. And I was kind of like, wow, that's cool. That's great. And then Witcher 2 came along.
But no, do it in the Geralt voice.
Wow, that's cool. That's really great.
Camel blood et toi. Hocus pocus abracadabra ars plethora.
How long did it take, do you think, in total to record The Witcher 3?
Well, it was recorded over about three or four years, actually.
Oh my God, that's so long.
Yeah, it was a long time. The first trailers and for E3 and things like that, it was about 4 years ago, 4 years ago. My estimate is over 16,000 lines of dialogue just for Geralt alone, so that's just Geralt.
16,000?
yeah, and that's lines of dialogue. A line of dialogue could be four words or it could be, 34 words.
Although he is a man of few words, he doesn't prattle.
He doesn't
too much.
No, he mostly goes fine,
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 fine, fine. I'll open it again. Care for a game of Gwent?
That's the one that everybody seems to want to hear. So,
hey, Julia, you care for a game of Gwent?
Wouldn't mind a round of Gwent.
What would you say is the best thing about getting to be Geralt? Do you sort of live through him a little bit?
I do, actually. Well, I do other video games as well. I do lots of voiceover work, but with Geralt, I've had what's a pretty rare opportunity to get to know the character and to follow him on his journey through three games.
Did you bring in some of the sarcasm? Because there's some really sarcastic moments in Witcher 3.
Oh yeah. Well, I think a lot of it's the writers.
Yeah.
A lot of it's the writers. But me and the director, often, if we think something could be done differently or done perhaps better, we'll call them up and say, look, we're just doing this section and we think this could be different, could be better. What do you think?
Come on, you're a handsome guy in your own way. Geralt, please. Cut the crap.
So,
okay, cool.
So they're very open. The CD Projekt Red has been very open to ideas.
Cool.
But, I have to give credit to the writers. They've been actually really, really good.
Aww.
They write the sarcasm in there. I just interpret it.
A little bit of magic. Well, thank you so much, Doug, for joining us. It's amazing. I can honestly, we could make like a series of 38 videos with all the questions I want to ask him. But don't forget to join us. And of course, hit subscribe and like if you like the video. We'll be back with more from Doug very soon.